If danger approaches, the best thing to do is seek shelter. But what if this isn't possible?
Plants, they are stuck where they grow. They cannot run away in the face of danger. Like if we see something coming at us, we will move out of the way or hide. So this is a good example. So here we have damage, physical damage, it looks like, from something big that passed here probably.
Seaman Stoll is finding out how plants manage to survive being damaged in order to be able to help plants improve their survivability in the future.
They can get damaged just from storms, from human activity, and herbivores, so big grazers, but also small caterpillars.
Exactly which vital processes take place within the microcosm of plants when they become damaged is not completely known today. Not yet. In this plant, called Arabidopsis thaliana, or tailcress, here at the Swedish University of Agricultural Sciences, Simon Stoll is intent on finding the plant's secret defenses.
So we are looking at the very early phases, within an hour, what is happening after the damage in the cells, what processes are being switched on or switched off.
The leaf gets a small tweezer pinch, and then something happens. Inside the plant's cells, we find calcium. Normally, the levels are low. But in the event of trauma, there is a sharp increase in calcium for a short period. A calcium wave then spreads throughout the plant as a warning signal. Simon Stoll wants to find out what happens when this warning signal sounds.
Depending on how severe is the damage, this then can actually trigger a small wave of the other cells reacting on that initial point of damage. You can compare that to an alarm system. So here you see another very good example. Yeah, this is only a skeleton of the leaf yet. So the veins are still there. But the bug has eaten everything in between the veins. And that's something peculiar. So it's something we see also from our studies. Once you hit one of the big veins, then you get a bigger response going on in the plant that actually goes throughout the whole plant. So maybe it is a way of the bug of trying to avoid that response.
Simon grew up in the city of Bruges in Belgium, far away from the Swedish forests. But even then, the curiosity was there.
Fascination already came from being very young, just trying to find out, you know, how does this work? Ah, and what is behind that? And how does that, so kind of drilling down to what is below that? So I think that really got me to study biology in the first place. And then also molecular biology, so where we really try to drill down to those molecular processes, to what is going on.
The calcium wave that washes through a stressed plant triggers vital processes. And Simon Stoll has seen that special enzymes, called proteases, are activated when the plant signals that damage has occurred. The proteases can affect proteins, the cell's workers. By cleaving the proteins, they can turn them off or on, move them to another location, or change their function. And right now, Simon Stoll's team is mapping all of the proteases that go to work in case of injury, as well as which healing processes they control.
Plants are remarkably good at regeneration. And we are investigating if proteases are indeed involved there. And that is one way of overcoming those the damage of just regenerating a completely new organ or you chop off a branch and a completely new one comes there. If you do that with a human, it doesn't work that way. It always amazes myself that once you kind of find a novel finding, something new, for yourself to kind of start believing in it, it also takes a while. So I really hope to come to this stage where I'm like, oh, okay, wow, there is now this body of knowledge that we created. What do we do now with it?
Simon Stoll hopes to even help people and animals as well as plants with his research.
One such idea is to try and make pesticides more selective.
In agriculture, pesticides are used against harmful insects or fungal diseases. But the poison also kills off some life that isn't doing any harm. Simon Stoll wants to utilize his findings for developing a pesticide where the toxicity is only turned on when it is actually needed. And that is upon the signaling of the proteases.
So for example, when a caterpillar is munching on the crop, only then is the pesticide toxic, and not, for example, when a pollinator is coming into contact accidentally with the pesticide, ingests it, it should not be killed by those pesticides. At least that is the hope.